guys, Happy New Year! We are officially 1 week into 2015, and I don't know about you, but I'm super excited for making this my best year yet. Today, I'm gonna share 5 questions that will help you close 2014 with a bang and create an amazing year for yourself in 2015. These questions are based on my own year-end review that I've done for myself these past couple years, and they've just been so helpful in helping me reflect and steer myself in the right direction. So without further ado, question one. What were the highlights of 2014? So write down the most important and biggest moments that you've had this past year and try to write down at least 10 things. What I do is at the end of each month, I kind of write down my highlights from that month, and at the end of the year, I kind of just pick the highlights from those highlights. And I do this because I think it's so important to remember your best moments and the moments that made you the happiest or the most excited in that year, because you want to cherish those moments forever. I believe that a few years down the line, you're probably not going to remember a lot of these moments and memories from 2014 unless you write them down. And so just write down the things you want to remember, the things that you want to capture and keep forever about your life. Question number two, what did you learn in 2014? What were your biggest lessons? So write down all of your life lessons that you learned this year, and also tie it to the experiences that you had and the reasons why, or the story behind how you kind of learned that lesson. It's important to kind of capture this wisdom and keep it with us forever. You know, what I do is I keep a notes section on my phone where I kind of write down, you know, phrases or the kind of lessons that I learned throughout the year. It's so important because you don't want to make the same mistake twice. You know, if you've experienced something, you live and learn. Make sure you kind of keep that knowledge and wisdom, and you're just gonna be a better person in the future if you are mindful of the lessons that you learned. Question number three, how did your life evolve in 2014? This one's about growth. Look at what you accomplished this year. How is your life different today compared to what it was January 2014? How are you different from who you were 1 year ago? This question is super important because you want to make sure that you're growing and that you're constantly evolving. If you notice that you or your life haven't changed that much in the past year, then maybe you should consider taking a little bit more risk in 2015 or learn something new, you know, try new things. Make sure that you're not too stagnant and that you're not too comfortable, because, you know, we always want to be growing and moving up. You want to level up. Moving forward, question number four is, what do you want to invite into your life in 2015? What do you want to experience and what do you want to feel? This is where you can write all of your intentions, everything that you want to invite into this year, everything that you desire. Whatever you decide to write, it should make you happy and excited for this year. You know, you can list any habits that you want to create, anything you want to learn, what do you want to improve on, any places that you want to travel, things you want to do. Put them all in this space. And feel free to list any goals that you have for 2015, but make sure that you don't list too many. Because if you list too many goals, it kind of falls into that category of New Year's resolutions that don't ever really happen. What's important is that you pick a small handful of important goals to you that you can focus and commit to. You have to believe that these goals are very doable, and you have to know that you could commit to making these happen. Also, make sure that you put these goals and intentions in some sort of notes that you can review constantly. You know, try to review them once a week, every day, every night, as often as possible, because the more that you review them, the more focused you can be on making them happen. And that's how you create your amazing year in 2015. Final question, question number five is, what is your theme for 2015? Pick one word or one short phrase that could be your focus for 2015. Your theme is your guiding light that will help you prioritize your life if you ever face a dilemma or you have to make a decision, or if you kind of fall off the path and become discouraged. Your theme should be on top of all your goals and intentions. You know, it kind of leads the way. My theme for 2015 is flow, and that means that I want to be in a relaxed, productive state, to be operating at my optimal level. And flow also means that I want everything in my life to flow in congruency, meaning I want everything that I want to do, everything I have in my life to be aligned with my purpose, you know, to be aligned with who I am and who I want to be. And if it doesn't fit that, then feel free to release that from my life. And so that's what flow means to me in 2015. I want to know, what is your theme for 2015? Let me know in the comments below. So that's it for my 5 questions, but I also have a bonus tip for any one of you who want to kind of dig deeper into making your year even more amazing. I highly recommend creating a vision board for 2015. A vision board is a visual board of images of things that you want to invite into your life and images that inspire you. So it's very similar to question number 4, where you list your goals and intentions, but in a visual format. And images are just so powerful that once you see an image of something, your brain kind of relates it to reality, because seeing is believing. And so kind of the more that you see it, the more you can believe it can happen and it can be your reality. So having a vision board on top of, you know, all of your goals and intentions is just adding like another oomph layer, you know? I mean, a vision board is a concept that kind of deserves its own video, so I'm just gonna leave it at that and let you Google the rest yourself. All right, that's it for today. Thank you so much for watching. I hope this helped, and I hope you create an amazing year for 2015. If you like this video, please share it with your friends and make sure you subscribe to stay updated with my videos. I'll be uploading every Wednesday of this year, and I'll sprinkle a few videos here and there. But yeah, that's it. I love you guys, and have a beautiful day. Bye!